Hi everyone, Varun here again from Strength Studio. So today's topic, I wanted to briefly speak on dieting for fat loss and transitioning into that maintenance phase for life. All right. So by now, we can all agree that in order to lose fat, we would need to be in a caloric deficit, which would mean that the energy in or the food that we intake needs to be less than our expenditure. So we either eat less, move more, or a combination of both. You can check out the last video that I did. I did have some tips on how to do that. So moving on, there are different types of diet, and like for example, like we have the low carb, the high carb, the keto, the vegan, balanced diet, the if it fits your macros crowd. And most diets will have a similar structure or these pillars that would be recommended for efficiency, for health, so on. And they would revolve around enough protein, essential fatty acids, your micronutrients from vitamins, minerals, you know, enough fruits and vegetables. And everything else is really gonna be preference in terms of your fat to carb ratio, your meal timing, the kind of pattern that you would like to have. And this depends on your preference, lifestyle, your financial status, and so on. All right. And with all those different types of diet, I can point out a meta-analysis from Johnson 2014, and it did state, because different diets are favorably tolerated by individuals, the ideal diet is the one that is best adhered to by individuals so that they can stay on that diet as long as possible. So the one that's gonna work the best for you is the one that you can stick to for the length of time that will give you the results, right? And it's gonna be the one that you prefer. Okay, and there are also a couple of ways that you can do that. Now, you could lose weight and take the slow approach, and you know, this could help you build habits over time, you know, not rush the process. And this could also work for lighter individuals, leaner individuals, physique athletes, so on. But there's also a case for a rapid fat loss and a time and a place for it. So for example, if you have more fat to lose, your high-end body fat, like obese individuals, this could help because it would help increase motivation, get the scale moving a lot faster, especially when there's less diet fatigue up front. So for example, you're gonna have a 300 pound person. Let's just say they need 3000 calories to maintain their diet, their weight, and we put them on a 1500 calorie deficit, all right, which is gonna be equal to like around 3 pounds a week. So after a period of dieting, they're gonna feel motivated, the weight is gonna be dropping, and you will have some metabolic adaptations through eating less food and, you know, other things. And you could also raise calories over time as well, and they will still be in a substantial deficit where they would still be losing weight. So this could show that the way that you diet doesn't necessarily mean that you have to eat that way the rest of your life. So these low calorie approaches could help get the weight off quickly, but you need an exit strategy. You need to be able to still build some sort of habits so that you can fall back on when you get off this diet. This is gonna be things surrounding your portion control, your awareness of calories, not eating till fullness, you know, things that can help you maintain that weight, especially for the general public, or these clients that don't have extreme goals, because weight maintenance is something that we need to teach and we need to adopt a lot more, because it's also harder for some people because it's also not goal driven. For example, you could jump on a diet and, you know, you can get going, you see the scale moving, but having to maintain your weight, it's something people don't grasp, all right? And you're not always gonna have a food scale, you're not always gonna be able to, you know, you don't always wanna live your life in a diet or a deficit or in this weight loss cycle, but you still, so that's why in practicing weight maintenance within the diet would help, so when you get off, you'll be able to maintain it, so that you could practice those good habits, control your weight, and, you know, just enjoy living. All right, so thanks for tuning in, guys. I would definitely love to, you know, dive into this a lot more. So if anybody has questions or, you know, want me to expand on anything, feel free to reach out. And yeah. Thanks a lot and do share.